Hi everyone, it's Scott Giroux, just fresh out of Maple Power 2020 D365 Saturday, and I was talking about powering up your Canvas apps using the Power Apps component framework. So I thought I'd share with you a few of the key takeaways. So welcome to another edition of Power Platform Unpacked. So one of the things at Maple Power 2020 was that we went to share a fun fact about Canada. And since I've moved to Canada recently, one of the things that I really have to get my mind around is the sheer size of the landmass compared to where I'd come from, which is the UK, which is tiny in comparison. So I was looking at the percentages of landmass and the ownership and what land was actually as in a developed state. And so I thought I'd create a power app, a Canvas app to learn about this trivia. And one of the things when if you've written Canvas apps is you'll know that getting a drag and drop style interface is quite tricky. You have to go through some hacks to achieve it. And if you've ever done any of those HR type tests where you have to learn about maybe GDPR or about internet safety, and then you've got to kind of drag facts to see if they're true or false. Well, if you wanted to do something like that in Canvas apps, well, it's quite tricky. And so what I did is I built this app with this drag and drop functionality to kind of test your knowledge. And what I was trying to demonstrate is that one of the very special things about the Power Platform, unlike any of the competitors, is that we've got this hugely rich Canvas app, low code, no code type environment that you can do very, very complex things. But Microsoft promised this sort of no cliffs paradigm where if you hit a cliff and you find that you can't actually develop any more functionality that you actually the way you want to work, and in this case, drag and drop, well, enter in Visual Studio or VS Code, Azure, so that you can then create components and extend it. So the great thing is you don't have to pick sides. You don't have to choose, am I a low coder or am I a pro coder? We've got this really rich ecosystem that brings the two things together. Now, back in August 2019, I was talking to a few people about a thing that I do. It's just one of those things that I have when I'm learning a new language. I will always try and write lemmings. And lemmings is this cool game that I used to play when I was a kid. And it's a simple, I love it because it's such a simple concept, this idea of these little lemmings walking around that have these little powers that you can dig and you can build and you can stop other lemmings. A really simple challenge. And so I thought, okay, can we do that in Canvas apps? And we were talking amongst ourselves and we're thinking, you know what, probably we'll have to use a pro code. We'll have to use the Power Apps component framework to actually enhance that to achieve it. But I set about trying to do it and I soon found that actually I could do it without using the PCF. And I've spoken a lot in previous videos about having to decide whether or not you really need a PCF component, this pro code component that can embed inside a Canvas app. And so I found that actually you can push the platform a long way before you have to go into that pro code style. And drag and drop is just one of those things that I think that the hacks that you have to go to achieve drag and drops are sufficiently justifying actually going into and creating a code component. But one of the things I was talking about at the Maple Power Conference was the ethos that you have to take. You have to think like an app maker. If you are a pro coder building components today for Canvas apps, and do bear in mind at the point in time of recording this, we don't have GA yet, it's not general availability, so it's still an evolving platform, and you know, all of the phrases like progress over perfection come into play here. There are still challenges, but we are getting to the point, and it's March 2021, where we currently it looks like it's going to go into GA. So it's not that far off. But if we are looking at building these components, then thinking like an app maker allows us to create a component that just does what we need to do in terms of extending the platform and nothing else. So a really good point that I was demonstrating of this in when we were looking at this drag and drop component was, okay, I had this component, which you can go and get the source code to. I'll put a link there. But it did drag and drop very well, but it didn't try and do everything. It didn't try and take over my Canvas app, because it's very easy to fall into this trap. It's very easy to start. Once you're into the pro code, actually, well, I'm going to start adding more and more functionality to that component until you've actually got a black box that the app maker really can't do very much inside of. And so a good example is in the app, it had a little label that said, you need to drag items here, or it might say there are no items, drag items. And so that the label visibility was dependent on whether or not there are any items in the collection. And so I could have built that label into the control itself. But what I did is I chose not to, because what about styling of that label? You may want that label to be an icon. You may want it to have other functionality, some buttons on it. And so as soon as if I built that label into my Canvas app PCF component, so that I could put maybe a text box to say, okay, well, what message do you want to display if there's no items? I've locked it in. And it's a black box that the app maker can't change. So the key message, I think, the key takeaway, when you're thinking about designing these PCF components for Canvas apps, you're powering up Canvas apps and you're enabling the app maker to deliver functionality. You don't want to start taking over. You want to try and keep that functionality as small as possible and as specific as possible to extend the functionality, but not replicate functionality if you can avoid it. So there we have it. A really simple message, but the future of PCF inside Canvas apps is really exciting. And I'm certainly going to be doing a lot more speaking on this subject, especially as the closer we get to GA. And we may even start to see ISVs creating components that you can then start to use in your Canvas apps. But if there is a PCF component that you think this would be really, really good to have when I'm creating my Canvas apps, do let me know in the comments. I'd love to hear. Maybe I even might have a go at building it. And make sure you subscribe to my channel so you can hear about all of the other stuff that I'll be talking about in terms of PCF as we approach GA in Canvas apps. Also, if you want to check out, I have learn.develop1.net, a course on building PCF components in model-driven apps. Lots of really good stuff there, which will be equally applicable to building components for PCF components for Canvas apps. Thanks for listening, and I'll see you next time on Power Platform Unpacked.